We have several announcements this morning, so before I do go on the screen, I have some things that I can get out of here.
Good morning, one quick announcement today. In commemorative plaques for the 60th anniversary that David and Wendy Clay have made and donated to the church as a fundraiser, is in the hallway today. If you'd like to purchase any, they're $10 a piece. Because we'll have them also next week also during the luncheon. Thank you.
Good morning. We've got a couple now. One is starting September 22nd. That's not the next 17th. Following year, we'll start a 5-week study on Psalms 23. Also, there's a sign-up sheet out in the on the table outside the sanctuary. Also, I request the birthday party luncheon next week. Do not bring desserts. We're going to have cake, so do not bring desserts. But what we do need is vegetables. So bring vegetables instead of
Good morning. Just a reminder for the youth to be here tonight at 5 o'clock from 5 to 7. And for the adults, please check our sign-up board out there for suppers, for snack suppers for our youth. Also, Wednesday night at 6:30, those who want to sing with us, show up at 6:30. Thank you.
And the word of the instruction is this. In the order of worship, we have what we call the sharing of the peace. I want us to do it in an orderly way. And that is that instead of running all over the sanctuary to greet friends, let's just greet those who are adjacent to us. Basically, because we could have greeting in the other manner, which is howdy moment, but this is a liturgical moment of sharing the peace. So do it just with the people who are at your proximity. That's it.
Also, further announcements for this week.
I'm announcing that we're having the Altar Guild meeting on Tuesday at 2 o'clock. I must change this week and decide if we want to change it at our next meeting. So it will be in the library and we'll see you all on Tuesday.
Give her the mic next time.
Okay.
What? Give her the mic.
So you're talking Altar Guild meeting Tuesday?
Tuesday night.
Tuesday night, and then what? On the announcements it says 2 o'clock?
Right.
Tuesday afternoon in the library.
Oh,
all right.
Also, Brendan. Remind everyone that UMW will begin again this coming Thursday.
That was one of the announcements I believe was that this coming Thursday, the 10 o'clock, the UMW day circle will start meeting, and then at 7 p.m. there will be the night UMW night circle. Okay. All other announcements for this week are on the back of your bulletin. You'll see the different activities that are happening throughout the week. Also, as Terry mentioned, next Sunday is a very special Sunday in the life of our church, where we celebrate our birthday. We will have the covered dish luncheon following the service at 12:30 back in the fellowship hall. Terry did mention about not bringing desserts. He did mention about bringing vegetables. Well, we also, as women and as cooks, we know you need more than vegetables. We also do need meat or meat dishes, casseroles, salads. We need all of those as well to go with our dessert, with our birthday cake. And many of us always try to bring a couple of dishes because we want to have plenty for everyone that comes for this special occasion and that our visitors will feel welcome. And we and want to stay.
Enunciate more.
Enunciate more? All right. Also, we have in each pew an attendance register pad. If you will fill that out, put your name, any changes in address or email, we would appreciate it. I believe that's all the announcements we have. Let us now prepare our hearts for worship.
Oh.
Judy Van Rosenbeek. And we pray for those prayers and those individuals that are very close to our hearts and are personal to us. So in a time of silence, let us go to God in prayer. Most gracious and loving God, we are thankful on this day to be present in your house of worship, to bring you our praise, our song, our thanksgiving, for you are indeed a loving and compassionate. We pray on this day for those who suffer devastation from the natural forces of nature, for people in the Bahamas who have lost lives, livelihood, communities. Oh Lord, in that mercy. We pray, oh God, for our community here in Western Hills. We pray for people all around us, especially those who are in need of community, in need of substance. In need of freedom, in need of freedom from poverty, from crime. Oh Lord, in that mercy. Dear God, now open our minds and our hearts to hear your word in such a way that your word becomes our calling. We are then to respond to that. For the calling in our lives, Lord, in that mercy. Pray this in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. He who taught us to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth.
Thank you. I've got a real weird person, 321, and also it's going to have an estate sale. I don't know her name. I met her, but... How are you feeling?
Good morning.
Jerry Bain died. Jerry Bain, he worked for Al.
These songs, specifically, I want you guys to listen to the lyrics. Because Baby Mason is getting baptized today. There's a lot of symbolism in the lyrics. Because his love rains down on us like waterfalls. Ocean deep, his love is there. He's mine and I'm yours, so on and so forth. So really listen to these lyrics. It ties in with baptism, so take the Baby Mason. The lyrics are going to be on the screens. So if you know the song, if you kind of get the tune, then jump on it.
Find you in the mystery, the ocean's sea.
Children, come forward at this time.
Good morning.
Good morning.
How are y'all? Tired. Whoa, sorry.
want y'all to all stand up. Did you know the Hokey Pokey? Come on, stand up, Italy. Stand up. Jake, stand up. Maddie and Rachel, start them off in the Hokey Pokey. Come on. You put your right hand in, you put your right hand out, you put your right hand in, and you shake it all about. You do the Hokey Pokey and you turn yourself around. That's what it's all about. All right, that's enough Hokey Pokey for the moment. Now what's the last verse in Hokey Pokey? You put your whole self in, you put your whole self out, you put your whole self in, and you shake it all about. You do the Hokey Pokey and you turn yourself about. That's what it's all about. Very good, now y'all sit down. Okay, today we're going to talk, Raul's going to read to us about Luke. And during this particular sermon, Jesus was speaking to a bunch of his followers about how he's kind of getting tough on them, saying it's not always easy to follow Jesus. It can be very difficult because you have to give your whole self, just like the Hokey Pokey is talking about. You put your whole self in. What does following Jesus mean? Anyone? Come on, Bella. Believing in him. It's more than that. It's doing all the things we can, loving people even though they're not, may not be the most popular people, like at school. If y'all are following Jesus at school, you may need to talk to someone that's not included in all your groups, who's an outcast at recess. There's all kinds of people that are not popular at school. Being a Christian, you need to be nice to these people, reach out to these people. Do y'all understand? So you need to be, that means being a Christian lots more than just on Sundays. Every day. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. And all the time during the day. Okay? It's true. And well, we're always Christians on Sundays, but we need to do it more than that. Even during football season. Alright? Alright. Y'all bow your heads. Dear God, thank you for your Son. Thank you for showing us how to follow him. That's what it's all about. In your Son's name. Amen.
On behalf of the whole church. church, I ask you, do you renounce the powers of wickedness, reject the evil powers of this world, and repent of your sin? Do you accept the freedom and power God gives you to resist evil, injustice, and oppression in whatever forms they present themselves? Do you confess Jesus as Lord and Savior, put your whole trust in His grace, and promise to serve Him as your Lord, in union with the church which Christ has opened to people of all ages, nations, and races? Will you nurture this child in Christ for the church, that by your teaching and example, he may be guided to accept God's grace for himself, to profess his faith openly, and to lead a Christian life? What a joy it is to receive into my arms this child. Beautifully dressed. What name is given this child? Mason Bradley Shaver. I baptize you in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Spirit. May God, who has loved you and chosen you, fill you with His Spirit, that you may walk in righteousness all the days of your life. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, we pray. Amen. Now I want you to meet Mason. Now talk about someone who can wear a white tuxedo. I want you to see people in your church, Mason. People that love you. People that will show care for you. People that will teach you in Sunday school. People that will teach you how to sing. And your grandmother that will teach you the beat of the bass. These are your people who love you and they will nourish you. Thanks be to God. Thanks be to God. Isn't he a what? Let me show him to the choir. You can only see him if I bring him to you. He is precious. Precious.
Thank you.
children are in prayer of elimination. Lord,
open our hearts and minds by the power of your Holy Spirit, that as the scriptures are read and your word proclaimed, we may hear with joy for the sake of us today. Amen.
Our first reading of the Holy Scripture this morning comes from the Old Testament, from the book of Jeremiah, chapter 18, verses 1 through 11. The word that came to Jeremiah from the Lord, "Come, go down to the potter's house, and there I will let you hear my words." So I went down to the potter's house, and there he was working at his wheel. The vessel he was making of clay was spoiled in the potter's hand, and he reworked it into another vessel as seemed good to him. Then the word of the Lord came to me. "Can I not do with you, O house of Israel, just as this potter has done?" says the Lord. "Just like the clay in the potter's hand, so are you in my hand, O house of Israel. At one moment I may declare concerning a nation or a kingdom that I will pluck up and break down and destroy it. But if that nation concerning which I have spoken turns from its evil, I will change my mind about the disaster that I intended to bring on it. And at another moment, I may declare concerning a nation or a kingdom that I will build and plant it. But if it does evil in my sight, not listening to my voice, then I will change my mind about the good that I have intended to do to it. Now therefore, say to the people of Judah and the inhabitants of Jerusalem, thus says the Lord, look, I am a potter shaping evil against you and devising a plan against you. Turn now, all of you, from your evil way and amend your ways and your doings. This is the word of God.
King, going to wage war against another king, will not sit down
sent the delegation and asked for terms of peace. So therefore, none of you can become a disciple if you do not give up all your possessions. The Gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. Thanks be to God. Please be seated. May the words of my mouth, the meditations of our hearts, be acceptable unto thy sight, O Lord, our rock and our deliverer. Amen. There's a story that involves Tabiette. We were in worship in a contemporary setting in Heights, Arlington Heights. I was sitting next to him because it was not my time to preach. And we sang a song that the song in its lyrics says, broken, break me, so that I may be whole. Break me. Break me. So that I may be whole. And so he looked at me and goes like this. What does this mean? Why would I want God to break me? Why do I seek discipline from the Lord in such a way that in breaking me, it's going to hurt? Why would the songwriter write this contemporary song with this plea? Break me. So I told Tommy, I'll talk to you after the service. And so we did. We're able to speak that when one is in God's presence, in order to be fashioned to God's will, many times we need to deal with the things that keep us from living according to God's will. And for those things to be purged, it requires time, endurance, patience, sacrifice. I think I was talking about Mary Jo and Gene Chapman in their celebration of 70 years of marriage. In order to make a marriage work, be faithful in it and to it, it requires all of those things. Betty Burroughs is a good friend. Betty, in her time of retirement, decides to enroll at TCC because there is a pottery class. And as it happens, we who knew her says, I wonder how long this is going to last. But she took it seriously. She took it so seriously that as she progressed and learned the technique of being a potter, she would come and tell us all about it. Even to the point it says, okay, I think I've heard this story before. But being good friends, we listened. As a consequence of her taking on pottery, she said, I'm going to show you my progress. So one day, she brought me this little bowl, this little vessel. And I looked at her and I said, so Betty, what can I do with it? She looked at me and says, well, you're the preacher. You should know. You can hold water. It has many uses. Then she says, I'm giving you a little bowl. Now I'm going to give you a bigger one. So I ask the same question. What should I use it for? She says, well, you can use it as a baptismal fountain. A bowl by which to baptize people and children into the Christian faith. And one day, she brought me what was then her work. And I didn't have to ask what to use it for. I knew that the use and function of this plate was for communion. It would hold the communion bread. How wonderful it is to be able to see the creativity of people and how through dedication and love, wonderful items are produced that make us happy, that allow us to be serviced through them. But this story in the Old Testament doesn't only speak of a potter who fashions wonderful works. There is a current, a dynamic within this passage that should cause us to tremble. 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 And that is that even God, in fashioning the clay vessel, fashioning the work of love, many times has to get rid and refashion the clay back of the spinning wheel to take the form that the potter wants the vessel to take. Yes, happy birthday. God in love and in care for us has fashioned us in such a way that we should naturally respond to the impulse of His love. We're fashioned that way. We're fashioned to help one another. We're fashioned to encourage one another. We're fashioned to express love and not hate to each other. So what is the state of life? I heard it this week in light of the mass shootings. One might say that our society is living with a wave of violence, of hate, of condemnation. So what then must the church do to respond to the evil that's in our world? Allow the Spirit of God to move us in ways that feed, in ways that care, in ways where we provide a needed service to those around us. Potter. It's a wonderful imagery. When we come to worship, we come to worship in a personal way, in an individual way. But we also come to worship as a community. Let us, at this moment, feel how, in participating in worship, we are being fashioned after God's will. Feel the forgiveness of God being fashioned into our faith. Feel the inclusion of God for all people being fashioned into us this day. Feel what it means and how it feels to be loved by God. Three things are essential in this parable. The potter, who in many ways is representative of God. The clay, we listen to the next one that is so essential. Water. Water is needed in order to fashion the purpose of God in our lives. Water. Cleansing water. Water. Water that softens. Water that allows the potter to be creative and allows the potter to fashion. Water. The waters of our baptism is the water that claims us. The water that fashions us. Be in accordance to God's will. So my dear friend Tommy Elliott, yes, sing that song that speaks about being broken. Allow the Spirit to indicate what part, what area of our lives needs to be fashioned after God's will. And then surrender. Surrender yourselves, knowing that God will take care of us. Knowing that God's purpose is always a purpose for good in and through our lives. So what am I? Am I a holder of water? Am I a utensil that serves the good to demonstrate and to exemplify God's love? Or am I a plate that on Communion Sunday holds the symbol of our faith and community, the body of Christ? Fill me, melt me, mold me. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Of faith.
And yes, I thought about it and talked with him, and he basically said, if you consider me, I will do my best. And that's all that Alan has ever done. So on this day, there is a liturgy in our book of worship for the installation of Minister of Music. Dear friends, let us recognize he who has responded to the call of God to the ministry of music in the church, to direct, to sing, and to play instruments, our ministries of Christ among us. Those called to these ministries need our loyal support and our prayers. Making music to the praise of God in the congregation is a ministry that requires devotion and discipline. So this is a question for you, Alan. Do you accept responsibility for this ministry? Will you be faithful to the disciplines of music? May the faith expressed by your music live in your heart, and that when you believe in your heart, practice in your life. And may God give you grace to offer your music in your life in faithfulness and consecration now and in the world to come. And now this is for you as a congregation. Dear friends, I commend to you Alan Brown, who has been given the ministry of music in the church. Will you sustain him with your encouragement and your prayers, and together seek to offer praise to God? If so, say we will.
We will.
Once again, Alan, we are blessed. He not only directs, he plays the piano, he plays the organ, he directs the bell choir, he leads the praise band, he also plays for the Spanish service. He has been doing this all along. And so, what a joy to have him. Let me pray over you and join me in this prayer. For his gracious and loving God, we are so blessed with Alan.
Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for watching over us and guiding us each day. During our times of difficulty and uncertainty, you always show us your steadfast love and comfort. Thank you, dear Father, for this wonderful church that shows love, support, and kindness to all. Help each one of us to grow in gratitude so that we will gladly share our gifts. I ask that you bless this offering so that we can continue to serve those in need here in our community. In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen.
Song of a vision, and
anyone wishing to join this congregation in the United Methodist Church may do so as we sing, Be Thou My Vision. Thank you.